I will tell you rather a sad story to illustrate the hunting territory's importance to understand our current world. It is 2010, 20th of February, 9:49 p.m. The BP Deepwater Horizon in the Macondo oil field in the Gulf of Mexico, about 70 kilometers off the Louisiana's coast. Suddenly, shocks shake the rig, and then an explosion and fire engulfs the platform. Out of 120 people, 126 people on board, 11 dies, 115 evacuated, amongst them 17 seriously injured but survived. In 2 days, the Deepwater Horizon sunk, but its fire has never gone out. It took 3 months to close the leaking wellhead, and during that 3 months, about 5 million gallons of oil contaminated the ocean. And even 2 years later, in 2012, still in 300 kilometers, oil dotted the Louisiana coast. The Deepwater Horizon was actually a fantastic building, one of the biggest on Earth at that time, and a very complex technical marvel. It floated on the water, and while floating, was exposed to waves, cyclones, and winds, and it still had to remain straight, and the drill pipe had to remain straight and stable. Everything happened through the drill pipe, drilling, cleaning, cementing, and even testing. In 2010, it drilled deeper than the Matterhorn. What went wrong with this fantastic technical marvel, which had actually several levels of barriers built in, and also 540 different alarms? So it was extremely well equipped against accidents. So what happened then? Was it just a case of unforeseen circumstances, or was it negligence? Was it haste? Or was it perhaps a lack of cooperation or failure in cooperation? My whole life was practically a quest to improve cooperation between people in order to achieve high performance. In order to perform well, you have to be able to focus on the tasks at hand, and also to understand the little details you have to deliver. And if you're working with others, you have to understand together what you have to deliver together and what are you responsible for together. The hunting territory is a method which practically appreciates the fact that we are territorial animals. That means that we tend to focus on our own territories, and we don't like our neighbors to interfere because it might affect our interests. And for the same reason, they tend to ignore what the other people around us are doing. But it also prevents us to understand that we are living in a highly complex world where we are highly interconnected. We cannot have the luxury anymore to isolate ourselves. We have to, and it's on this territorial overlap that then mentioned, that where we have to actually cooperate, where we have to realize what we have to do together, what are the problems. We have to give feedbacks, but also listen to feedback, and also share problems and solutions. Let's go back to the Deepwater Horizon, which was the very territorial overlap of different players, the stage of the drama. There were four companies involved. BP purchased the mineral rights from the federal agency who was responsible for the environmental safety. BP owned the project and was entirely responsible for it. BP hired Transocean, which owned and operated the Deepwater Horizon, and they also hired Halliburton to deliver the cementing work. So practically, these companies' territories overlapped, and on the very overlap, there was the Deepwater Horizon drilling unit. On the 19th of April, on the eve of the explosion, BP chairman sent a letter to the shareholders praising the company's fantastic financial record, saying that it actually done better than any other oil drilling company. And also praised the big improvements in safety. On the next day, on the 20th of April, four top managers from BP and Transocean flew to the rig to celebrate 7 years of without a lost time accident. On the same day, the crew was scheduled to finish the project, close the well for later oil production. Weeks before this visit, there were already problems hitting the surface on the rig. There were problems with the cementing plan and also the end of well activities. And Halliburton's cementing expert suggested a change which would have delayed the closure by some days, but also by $2 million. And I forgot to mention that this was a very, very big project. The Deepwater Horizon cost about $500 million. And this project was already late by 5 weeks, which cost BP an extra $50 million. That put an enormous pressure on the BP representatives on the rig. There were two BP representatives who had the final say in all major decisions. So when the Halliburton people suggested the change, the two BP representatives came up with another solution which practically bypassed that suggestion and didn't allow the delay of the closure. So that created already a hole on the territorial overlap between Halliburton and BP because there was no cooperation. The drama reached its climax on the next day, on the 20th of April, when there was a morning meeting between the two BP managers and the Transocean crew working on the rig and on the project. (clears throat) And a heated argument broke out between the transocean crew and the two BP managers, because in a test which was close to the end of the well activities, the transocean crew sensed that the mounting pressure in the pipe signaled the presence of gas. But the two BP managers read it actually differently, and they decided to go ahead with the last test, which meant to replace the heavy drilling mud in the pipe, which actually kept the pressure of the controlled the pressure of the gas, with lighter seawater. It was then that one of the transocean experts jumped up angrily and told, "This is why we have the blowout preventer for," and angrily left the room. And actually, that was the decision which later triggered the blast. Unfortunately, the blowout preventer didn't work. It was another hole on the already hollow territorial overlaps. The tension was still high in that room when a level above, the top managers of the rig and the VIPs celebrated the stellar safety record, ignoring completely what was going on one level below. And it was another territorial overlap devoid of cooperation and communication. So let's summarize what happened in the Deepwater Horizon platform that was the very overlap between all the players and the stage of the drama. There was a pressure from above by the top management to finish the job, because the name of the well amongst them was the well from hell. So they just wanted to get away from it as quickly as possible, and they put a pressure on the management. There was also a celebration going on between the top managers celebrating the stellar safety record. One level below, there was that argument which created another hole on the communication system and the territorial overlaps. And also, this whole platform became a gap to allow the gas to enter. And because of the tunnel vision caused by the arguments and the celebration and the parallel activities, for long hours, unnoticed, gas was bubbling up to the platform, and it, at 9:49 p.m., it set it alight, killing 11 people, seriously injuring 17, amongst them some of the VIPs. And then the Deepwater Horizon sank, and oil blackened the horizon. So what is the conclusion of this story? It is that the top management of the BP didn't realize that they had to have a responsibility on the territorial overlaps, and the middle management and the experts working on the rig actually belonged to that territorial overlap. They should not ignore what was going on. And the problem was, what is very often the problem, that the top managements don't like to hear bad news, which is against the advertisement, which was this PR bang, which became a sad bang. And the thing is, if there is no feedback system, we are under danger. When I was a coach, I used to say to my players, that don't focus on the God because it blinds you, and when blinded, you will miss the necessary steps that leads to the God. This is what we have to keep in mind. Thank you. Thank you.